And now, ladies and gentlepersons, yes, another fabulous B&B for you to stay in, or it's an inn. It's called the Inn at Cook Street, so I guess it's an inn, really. They have wonderful breakfast, wonderful sugar cookies, and we're sitting here with the two owners. I'm so excited to meet you both. It's John J. Wooldridge and Patrick Flaherty.
Welcome.
Flaherty. I got it right almost.
You were close.
I was close, but you'll feel very close after this interview because you'll feel like you know them and you'll want to come to stay here in Provincetown.
I hope so.
The Inn at Cook Street is... I guess it's on Cook Street, right?
Yeah, absolutely. We're at Cook and Commercial, right in between Commercial Street and Bradford Street.
And Cook is a very historical street for Provincetown.
So business is booming. The summer is starting. So tell us about your wonderful place.
Well, it's been a bed and breakfast for over 30 years.
But you haven't been here that long.
No. Patrick and I bought the inn just last year, so this is our first season. We open in May, and we stay open until after New Year's, so we have a nice fall season coming up, and a little bit of winter, which is great, because even after the tourist season of the swim and beaches, that tourist season leaves, we still have a beautiful town with nice weather, and there's lots of things to do, so people usually come pretty strongly all the way to New Year's.
We're here during the film festival week.
Mm-hmm, that's right, which is really big here.
It's becoming bigger and bigger mm-hmm. every year.
It's amazing, and it's great. It's great.
And so it's a little earlier in June than most people would be here, but mm-hmm. the weather's just been gorgeous.
The weather's gorgeous, yes. We had a little slow spring, but now it's here, and everything's blooming, and everything's green, and it's beach time, and it's entertainment time, and the town is... ready to go.
Hustling and bustling, as you can see in the background. You know, we're so lucky to be here. This is where my cameraman, Jack Siberine, has been staying here. Thank you so much for having Jack.
Oh, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure. It's been a pleasure to have you
here. I'm glad to hear.
And we're going to be having you here as well.
I'm going to be here too.
Yes.
I can hardly wait to be in the same place as Jack. You know, now we're like, I feel like we're living in different hemispheres. You know, I'm at the... Right. Salt House Inn, which is a bit further over. I'm still
not over the hill.
Over the hill. Yes, yeah, so on. So am I, some people say. But anyway, I just wanted this to be as campy as possible, so I wore my brand new shirt. This is new.
Beautiful shirt.
Thank you. I felt it was you. I don't know why. Did I speak to you mostly on the phone?
You did. You spoke to me from New York, yes.
You were so funny and campy. But you're a different person. You're tall, dark, and handsome. It's a different category there.
It can't be both. Can't be campy.
Well, that would be a first, actually.
All right. Well, unique is good down here.
Yeah. And you were a personal trainer?
I still am. I took a break for us to open the inn and get it going. And then as of next year, I'll be incorporating the business into the site. What I used to do is I used to run fitness weeks and fitness camps in Bermuda, as well as Boston and New York. And I would bring clients, 10 to 12 people, in with my trainers and my staff. And for 24/7, 9 to 12 days, you'd be with us under our control, trying to find out all about health and fitness and try to find your way to a better life.
Boy, do I need that. I'm like the wreck of the Hesperus here.
Yeah,
you know.
So we're looking forward to starting that and incorporating that into the guest house.
The housekeeper, whoever, the lady in charge, the femme de ménage over at the Salt House Inn, said to me, "You look better today." And I was like, "What? What are you taking my temperature? What did I look like yesterday?" So anyway, it's a laugh a minute here at the Inn on Cook Street. What's the difference between an inn and a bed and breakfast? Or is there any?
Well, for us, a bed and breakfast is you get the feeling of coming to somebody's home, where you have the comforts of a home. And what we look forward to is people coming and feeling like they're, you know, visiting one of their favorite relatives, you know, on the summer.
Nice.
If you remember when you were children and you used to go to beach resorts with your family, or you'd go to your favorite uncle's place on the beach. And that's kind of the environment we're trying to create here.
So I think you've succeeded.
Well, thank you.
Say something, Patrick.
Yes,
now the shy one.
No, I just had, as you know, guests come in. But
And yeah. What can you do? You have to.
Oh, absolutely. You stop in the end. And the good thing is, Provincetown, with the diversity of Provincetown there,
yes.
They're looking for shows. They want to go see Varla Jean, who's mm-hmm. one of the top drag performers here in town. And
yes, I know her, but I've never met her.
Yeah, and they're doing a show called Golden Girls, which is very popular here in town, so...
why am I not in that? Oh, I'm just doing a one-woman version of it now. Yeah.
No, but I mean, to follow up on what John said, really, this whole concept of our home, I mean, we've been very happy to hear people come in. And the first thing people say is when they come in, they go, wow, I feel like I'm sitting in someone's home. So the fact that they come in, they feel like they're sitting in someone's elegant home. And they feel, most importantly, relaxed. Because Provincetown is, and with our garden setting in the back, it's very... very serene, it's very relaxing. We're from New York, we've lived in New York for 20 years and
you seem like Cape Codders, you know, like really.
Yeah, no, we're New Yorkers and you know, transplanted from New York here to the Cape. And it's interesting because even when we came here on vacation, you may have experienced this. You know, we find that people come in, and we did this, remember when we first arrived in Pt.1 many years
sure.
vacationing here, it takes a day or two to get
out of your system. I had bus lag. I didn't expect that.
So they have bus lag, they have ferry lag, they have train, you know, they
Well, the ferry is just wonderful. Bay State Cruises, I have to keep plugging them because they're a sponsor. And also because I've never experienced a bad crossing, but some people have.
Oh yeah, we've been on a couple ourselves. But,
but it's a beautiful way to come in because it's like arriving on an island.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, it's like flying through heaven to get here for 90 minutes of absolute quiet and charm and serenity out in the ocean. There's nothing that chills you like the ocean.
True. Oh, yeah. And
then you must get that every day here. You can just walk right down to the beach and chill.
We're one block from the beach. We're one block from the beach.
Close?
Yeah, we're one block down. And I think certainly Jack, your cameraman, will be able to attest to this is at night and in the morning, I think people... sitting out in the garden, the birds, there are loads of birds here, and it's just very, very calm. It's a very peaceful setting. Mm-hmm. So coming here, another key differentiating point for us is we're in the middle of the art gallery district. Mm-hmm. So I was just pointing
paintings
to them.
Paintings aren't particularly loud.
Yeah.
Though my shirt is, but... so darling, who used to massage Betty Buckley?
Oh, I worked with Betty Buckley.
Yeah, John did.
Yeah, I worked for a company and we... do a lot of Broadway, TV, and movie, and some athletes as well.
What was she doing when you were working her
She was over? Working, she was...
Sunset Boulevard?
She was doing a cabaret, and she was getting ready for that. So we were working with her endurance and posture and getting her fit and ready for that
performance. Facing the audience, people don't know how much goes into these
exactly
preparations for the people, like... You know, for instance, we just did the Drama Desk so memorably, the awards. Mm-hmm. Jack did a wonderful, incredible job. I can't stop talking. Yay, Jack. That night, he had never done this before. I have to say this. And he just... Also, my career, that night, I caught lightning in a bottle.
Wow.
I mean, I got Neil Patrick Harris, Bryce Pinkham, Audra McDonald. Oh! And he caught the lightning in the bottle that night.
Great.
It was thrilling. Thrilling.
And she just broke, what, 6 Tony Awards?
Yes, she did. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we are just, I think you may know this, but we've both been long-term contributors to the Actors Fund in New York.
Oh.
So for many, many years, we've been members of the Actors Fund. And interestingly enough, this being our first season, we are going to be working with president of the Actors Fund in New York is Joseph Benicasa.
Okay,
we're working right now with them to see, not only have we contributed in the past, and we're big sponsors for the, you know, the arts, we're looking at doing some type of promotion here at the end for Broadway. Anybody that belongs to the Actors Fund in New York, LA, or within the country will get a special rate here with their, you know, as long as they can show that they're members of the Actors Fund.
Well,
so it's another way for us to contribute.
You're doing it right now. Because if it wasn't for the Actors Fund, I don't know if I'd still be alive, quite frankly. I lost my apartment in New York, and they helped get housed, I guess. That's the nicest way of putting it. And if it wasn't for, and I'm going to forget the young lady's name, she's no longer there, but they got me to where I am, and now I'm here praising the Actors Fund. And you see, they do great work, or if you consider this great work, which I do, but yeah. I hope you do too.
We consider
anyway.
It work.
Oh, well, thank
great
you.
Work, I'm sorry, not good, great.
It's a work in progress always. So you keep wanting, when am I going to interview Brad and Angelina? No, who needs it? But maybe this time, David Cronenberg, Deborah Winger, and Patricia Clarkson, who are being honored here at the film festival. And, you know, if you want to dish on any of these people, I'll give it to you.
We have, in our neighborhood here, we're very close. Provincetown Art Museum is right around the corner. So we consider them our neighbors.
Yeah, and that's celebrating 100 years of the beginning of the art colony here with the Hawthorne School.
I always wonder how they differentiate between the art, the artists, and the gay people coming here. I always think it's really the gay colony. You know?
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Sure.
And it just used the term artist as a euphemism, but it's very gay here, ladies and gentlemen. I like that, you like that, we like that, you like that, so.
Well, this morning at breakfast, one of our guests, we have many guests who are coming to Provincetown for the first time, and it's interesting. They know nothing about the town, and what's rewarding is when they leave, they're like spellbound. They go, "We cannot believe how magical this place is."
I know, I agree.
And then the other piece of
it is,
that's
why we're here, because it was so magical.
Yeah, and they were asking me. They were saying today at breakfast, one of the couples were saying, "Can you tell me when is Gay Pride here?" And I looked up and I said, "Gay Pride is here every day." I think you were here listening to that.
Every day of the week is Gay Pride. On my show, my career, I was one of the first out gay actors. Everybody knows that. And one of the people who started gay theater in America. I wrote the first play, AIDS, Fever of Unknown Origin. Still not published. But anyway, and I continue making gay television. And I just continue being gay. I'm here, I'm queer, I'm fabulous. Get used to it, okay? They're very used to it, 26 years.
It's fantastic.
They've been watching me get gay. So maybe we could see a little bit of your wonderful house now?
No,
sure,
absolutely. That'd
We'd
be great.
To show the gardens and some of the rooms.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and at first, I have to mention, before we turn off, who made these fabulous peanut butter and sugar cookies?
Our Chef Andrew, who does our breakfast every morning and then creates a snack for our guests in the afternoon.
Okay. May I?
Absolutely.
Oh, absolutely.
Please.
I said just grabbing it. It's called boarding house reach in my mother's era.
He has freshly baked snacks every afternoon that he puts out for the guests, which are just really, really quite good.
I can't wait to move in.
Yeah. Well, we look forward to hosting you. I know you're coming in later in the week, which would be great. Absolutely great.
Thank you so much. And now let's tally-ho to the garden and elsewhere.
Absolutely, let's go.